2022 now, for example, whatever tax I paid in 2021, I'll pay 10% extra in those quarterly, in those quarters. And that's what we call, that's what we call installment taxes. You pay it in bits.
You pay it in installments.
Exactly.
And there is the other element to do with the value added tasks or other taxes for the small businesses. How does, how, what is the difference between now that one and the income tax?
Okay, good. So there is the VAT or value added tax is completely separate from income tax. In actual fact, there's a law that is, there's the Income Tax Act and there's a VAT Act. Those are different, those are different taxes. They do not even, there's no other mix anywhere.
But the same person pays the same.
Exactly, both, yeah, same both. So VAT, as the name suggests, value added tax. It's a tax on value addition, just the way it is, tax on value addition. It's a tax that's levied on anything that has added value. So if you, if you're selling something that, most of the times when you sell things that have no addition, added value, there's no tax you pay. If you sell milk, raw milk, ideally it doesn't have tax. There's no VAT you can pay on it. If you sell wood like timber as it is, there's no VAT. There's no VAT that you impose on it because that thing is still in its raw form. So when you convert a raw product into something that is useful, so if you convert timber into furniture, that furniture now becomes something that has additional value. So tax is levied on that value addition process. It's a tax on value addition. It's very, very critical. So VAT is only levied on essential goods and services that there's a value added process in it. And value addition can be in conversion and also in delivery. A service delivery that is, that happens for example, I'm a consultant, I offer services. Since because of my knowledge and what I'm doing, there's a value that in that, so there's a VAT element to it. So yeah, basically the, what happens is just, and I need to get to this, it's very important to understand. VAT, the government defines products and services that do not, that have no VAT, or that you should not charge VAT on these products. If the product or service that you sell as a business owner is not in that list, then you should charge VAT. And even before that, so anything that is not on the government list of exempt or cannot, should not charge VAT, anything that is not on that list should be charged, should be, is a VAT, is a VATable, we call it VATable service or VATable good. I hope that's clear. It's very, very important. Anything that the government has not listed. So depending on what you do, you go to the government list and check, is this thing listed? It's not listed. Then ideally it's a VATable service or a good. And before you get, now if it's a VATable service or a good, now you have to go to the next stage. What are the requirements to, for you to charge the VAT on that good or service? The requirement is, if your business turnover, annual turnover, annual sales in a year will exceed 5 million, then it's a requirement to charge VAT. So regardless of whether you're a small business owner or a large business owner, if as long as your turnover, what you sell, what you make, the money that comes to your business is, will exceed more than 5 million in a year, then it's a requirement to charge VAT. Very key. You, then another aspect that is very, very important for business owners to understand, you should never charge VAT if you're not registered. You should never charge VAT. It's an offense, which has penalties and can, I think, can lead even to imprisonment.
We registered in which sense, with the ETR machine or with the, like a company?
It's a good question. So element, so taxation, when as a business owner, the first thing that you do, if you're a sole proprietor, your personal KRA PIN is your PIN, is your business PIN as a sole proprietor. But as a limited company, every time if you open it's a person on its own, it has to get its own PIN. Every person who gets a PIN, he's registered for what you call income tax. Everyone, that's standard, because everybody is assumed to be doing either being employed and earning an income, or doing business to earn an income, or to make a profit so that they pay tax on. So everybody becomes income tax registered. Then, so now VAT, if your business is eligible to for VAT, you add it to your PIN. So it's called a tax obligation, it's added. So you have to go to KRA and say, I'll be charging VAT and I'm eligible to charge VAT. You apply, then they register you to charge VAT. You cannot do that if your PIN has no VAT registration. Now what as soon as you get a VAT register, as soon as you're VAT registered, then there are other requirements that come into place. So one of the ways that they are trying to get hold of tax sheets and stuff like that is that, you see, if I just say I'm registered for VAT, I can, for example, not charge this customer VAT or charge this other one VAT. It can be a puzzle like that. So that will deny them revenue. So they require you as somebody who has already registered to get a what you call an ETR machine. It's an electronic tax register. An electronic tax register is like any, it's like a sales machine or a calculator sort of, that produces a receipt, a tax receipt. It shows the value of sale plus the value of VAT added plus it. Now the gross, the total sale value. So it shows, it splits down. So I have charged this customer 100,000, I've added VAT, it comes to now 116,000. So it shows the breakdown. The key thing about that tax register, you can only add things, you cannot delete it. So they require, as a requirement of a VAT registered person, is that you have, when you do a sale, you have to give an ETR receipt. The ETR receipt, once you produce an ETR, you cannot delete it from the tax register. That's why it's very unique. You cannot go and say, it was an error, let me remove. You can't. So it's a permanent record of a sale. And that's what they like. So what happens is that now they've made it a requirement that, for example, every time you do a sale, you have to give somebody, and you are charging VAT, you have to give somebody an ETR. So if you do a sale and don't give an ETR, it's an offense. There are penalties and that reports on that. That's very, very important.
Oh, but I've seen in Kenya people behaving like, do you want receipt or do you want no receipt?
Which is again how they play with the game. So yeah. And one of the elements to understand about VAT and why the ETR receipt is very important. So when you sell something with VAT, you declare to the government, I sold this item with VAT, and this VAT. And collect. So what happens? You collect VAT on behalf of the government. So if you sold something with VAT, you tell the government I sold it. Then you declare that I sold this item. This is how much it was before VAT. This is how much with VAT. Then the government knows that they'll collect from you this amount of VAT. But before you pay government that VAT, they allow you to claim any VAT that you paid on that item. So for example, let's give you an example. If you bought furniture for 10,000. Mm-hmm. Plus VAT, that's about 11,600. That's the cost you bought it at. If you sold the same furniture for 20,000 plus VAT, that's 23,200. So every month, it's an obligation to file a return saying how much VAT did you collect this month. So in that VAT return, I'll declare that I sold something for 20,000. The VAT was 3,200. But I'll also now claim and say, the same item that I bought for, I sold for 20, I bought it for 10,000, and the VAT charge was 1,600. So the government allows you to counterset those two. So you'll pay the government 3,200 less 1,600, so you now pay the government 1,600. They allow you to sort of offset. So before you offset, the government makes it important for you that you have to have a valid ETR receipt. So you can't offset something if you don't have a valid ETR receipt. So that's why it's very important to issue both an ETR receipt and also to collect ETR receipts from the person you're buying from.
You're buying from.
Yes.
Okay.